coming up.
He does have severe tingling and it's getting worse in his feet.
A crashed quad bike racer faces possible paralysis. Summer fun turns to fear and pain when a seven-year-old girl falls from a rope swing. And a high-speed crash on a motorbike leaves a young man fighting for his life.
Open your eyes for me, mate. We're just going to move you to the helicopter, mate, all right? How's that pain? You got to talk to us, eh?
In code one. In mission one.
Traffic westbound, rescue two's out of Mechanics Bay, eastbound, cover, cover bay. Come on.
The Auckland Rescue Helicopter Team are responding to a status 2 emergency. 32-year-old Ian McDonald crashed his quad bike while racing and may have broken his back. The motocross event is 10 minutes flying time southeast of Auckland at Kawakawa Bay.
Security.
Looks like we've got a bigger event going on over there about the 1 o'clock, 12:30, 1 o'clock.
Yeah, sort of.
Coast Guard Radio, Westpac Rescue 2's landing Kawakawa Bay, cancel sail. Okay, how are we looking down there, Artie, underneath?
The man of tail clear the ground.
Yep.
We've been called to somebody who's got a spinal injury. We don't know much about the patient at this stage. But quite clearly, we're at some sort of organised motorcycling event.
What's happened?
I got a guy who's rolled his quad. He's in flying pain.
Hey, guys.
Tingling down the right side.
Hi.
He's got a headache, and headache's coming from the back while he's flying pain.
Yep.
I can't really remember what happened before.
Okay.
I have a little bit of anterior grade amnesia.
Yeah.
He has pain, center line, sort of from C2 down to C5.
Yeah.
Okay. He does have severe tingling and it's getting worse in his feet.
Oh, yeah.
So far, Ian's symptoms are all indications of a serious spinal injury.
On his quad bike. It's come off. Was he KO'd?
We don't know, but
yeah, probably KO'd. He's got C spine pain. He's got increasing pins and needles. So we need to get an IV in. Yeah, have you got the IV gear here? Yeah, right there. Get that ready.
How sore is your neck at the moment? So it's pretty sore just lying still. How sore is your lower back if you're just lying still here at the moment? So that's pretty sore, yes.
Right, just a little prick coming up, mate. Just relax your head, huh?
The severe back pain is not the only worrying sign. Yeah. There's also tingling in his arms.
Those pins and needles are getting really bad again, eh?
How's the needles wearing?
Just put that on my hand.
In mission two, the Fitianga chopper team is responding to a status 2 call out.
4 POB, ETA, 15 minutes over.
7-year-old Jessica has fallen 20 feet from a rope swing and suffered serious injuries, including a badly broken femur. It's a 15-minute flight from Fitianga to reach her at a camping ground in Colville. Today, veteran crewman John Skiro is undertaking his 3,000th mission, although he's modest about the achievement.
This job to me, apparently it's 3,000, so. But the job ain't done until it's all done and dusted, mate, so.
7-year-old child who's had a fall, possibly a family on holiday, and fallen off a deck or out of a tree, perhaps.
This is our GPS here. Oh, and I can now see the ambulance there as well.
Okay, door's coming back.
Roger.
It's back and locked.
If you just creep forward a little more, that'll get the tail well clear. And you'll clear down there.
Roger.
Clear out. 10:33, chaps.
While John Skiro maintains the safety of the chopper, paramedic Bruce Kerr heads into the campground, where he's met by the patient's worried dad.
Mike's name?
Bruce.
Bruce, nice to meet you.
How you doing? Hello, Felix.
One child with a full leg.
What'd it fall from?
Swing.
Swing.
7 years old, Felix. Yeah. This is Jessica, 7 years old. Been swinging around on the swing up there and fell. And as you can see, you know, query fractured. Femur.
Certainly.
Yeah. At the moment, when she's sitting here, no pain. Any movement, it's up to 10 by out of 10.
Right.
So if you're lying still there now, it's not really that painful. No. Only if it moves or some guy touches it. Yeah.
Young Jessica is understandably fearful about the pain that could happen when they do have to move her.
Can I just stay on this?
Yeah.
You're right, darling.
We can stay on there for now, right, sweetheart?
No, I mean when I get onto the helicopter.
Yeah, you're right, sweet.
Have you got brothers and sisters up here too? Were they up swinging with you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
She was on the swing and she struggled to hold on and then she went fine.
Back at the scene of Ian's quad bike crash at Kawakawa Bay...
And a sharp spin there.
The helicopter medics need to ensure they make a full assessment of Ian's injuries before they move him.
So what we're going to do now, Ian, we've got IV access, which is good, because if we have any problems in flight, we can treat you. We just want to go through from the head again down and just check you out more thoroughly. So do you know if you were knocked out at all?
I don't think I was, but I can't remember the actual fall. So.
Yeah, okay. So, pain in the neck, whereabouts?
Just starts at the top, or at the base of the skull.
Yeah.
And there's a gap where it's fine, and then in between the shoulder blades.
Yes. So just grab my hands and just squeeze as hard as you can. Squeeze hard.
So my hands are still too.
Yeah, okay. No, he's got diminished strength there, so. Yeah. Shall we get him cracking? What we're going to do, Lance, is drive over to by where the machine is, so it's an easy transfer.
They need to treat Ian as though he does have a severe spinal injury and take all the precautions necessary to minimise any further problems.
Can we go a bit slower? Yeah, a bit slower again, yeah. Everyone just listen up. There's no hurry to go anywhere. We're just going to lift up gently, all in a straight line. On the count of three, just up about a foot. One, two, three.
Stretcher coming out now.
Yeah. Where's that sore?
Oh, my back.
Just lift up a little more in the middle of his back there. That's better, yeah.
You got enough there, Chris?
Yes, and one, two, three. How's that? One, two, three, and we'll walk around.
From here, basically, we transfer him to Middlemore, and they treat him with kid gloves, assuming he's had a spinal injury, whether he actually has or not. We don't want to make anything worse by having him sit up or, you know, walk from the ambulance into the helicopter. So, yeah, we'll get him to Middlemore, and the emergency guys there will hopefully get him sorted out.
Near Colville, the rescue chopper is ready to airlift 7-year-old Jessica to hospital.
Jessica's fallen off a big rope swing up in the bush away from the camp here, and her right leg it's definitely bent. So she's had some pain relief in the form of methoxyfluorine through the green atomizer here. Naturally, she doesn't want to be moved. She's comfortable. She's really comfortable like she is now, so we have to try and move Jessica and keep her as much as possible in the same way of lying that she is now. Okay, Jessica, we will be really careful because your dad's watching too.
Dad will be right here with you. It's
yeah.
Oh, she's a bit worried about getting moved, but she'll be right.
You're pretty brave. You must be more than 7 years old, I reckon
she is.
Yeah.
What we're going to do, that stretch underneath you is going to split apart.
You just take a big breath, Jessica.
Take a deep breath.
No, it's okay.
Take a deep breath.
Okay. Okay.
With no extra room in the chopper, Jessica's mum will have to drive to meet her at the hospital.
Oh, Jessica!
But Jessica clearly doesn't want her to go.
Okay, here we go.
I think she's going to Waikato, so we're going to head off there and make sure she's okay. She's a real toughie, that one. Yeah, real tough.
Here we go, Jessica, into the helicopter.
Okay, see ya.
Love you, Tony.
Okay, we're set and secure.
Yeah, roger that.
So ETA is 11:40. 11:40. Okay. Shut it. Door out. Roger. Door shut. Locked.
In Mission 3, the Fitianga-based chopper has taken an emergency call while returning to base.
We got turned around at the 309 road, which is near Coromandel. We're on our way back to Wiriyanga from Auckland. We received this job.
A young man is believed to have been evading police on a stolen motorbike when he crashed at high speed, causing severe internal injuries. It will take the chopper just 10 minutes to fly from Coromandel to the crash scene at Maramarua.
We've been responded to a motor vehicle accident today. We're unsure what the patient's injuries are or the status, but the ambulance crew on scene have requested for a helicopter. Quite a remote area, so we're assuming the person needs to get to hospital, time critical injuries, we'll assess it when we get there.
Okay, do you know when we're all secure?
Paper.
Okay.
Okay, you're getting close, it's going to be on your 11 o'clock.
Right, sorry.
Right under those power lines. The scene is in 3 o'clock now, up the hill.
Alright, I see.
And you're over the road now, your tail's clear of the trees. Yeah, roger.
Oh, that does it. Alright. Clear to go, gentlemen.
The bike rider has been given initial treatment by police and ambulance officers.
Was a motorcycle rider.
Yeah.
Police clocked him at 160Ks through State Highway 2.
Yeah.
And they've given a little bit of a pursuit. He's come down this road.
Yeah.
At which point he's actually come through the bend and he's low-sided the bike and slid into a gravel bank.
Yeah.
We've got some very, very, very tender abdo over the spleen.
Okay.
And looking at the way the bike's landed, it would have been his left side that's taken the big brunt.
Right.
So I'm a little bit more concerned that we've got some splenic injury.
Yep, sure.
All right.
Open your eyes for me, mate. Big and wide, big and wide, big and wide.
A ruptured spleen is a potentially life-threatening condition. David could be bleeding internally, and his continued loss of consciousness is a very worrying sign.
Open your eyes for me. We're just going to move you to the helicopter, mate, all right? How's that pain? You got to talk to us, eh?
At Maramarua, paramedic Russell Clark needs to get critically injured motorbike rider David to hospital quickly, although every move they make is excruciating.
Hello. Mate. I'm
going to give you some more pain relief, okay? A couple of deep breaths, mate, while we move you off the stretcher, okay? Hang on. I know.
You're going to feel a little bit of a drop to one side, okay? Everybody, over your head. All right. That's it.
All right,
now you're on a nice soft
stretch,
buddy.
Okay. Oh. All right. That's it, mate.
We'll come to the hover. We're going to do a pedal turn to the right. We're going to accept the tailwind, but we're going to have the ground sloping away from us.
Yep.
Okay, coming up.
Yes, thank you.
Auckland Hospital in about 18 minutes.
He's male who was travelling high speed on his motorbike today. He's come off his motorbike with police in pursuit.
He's run away from the police, and then he's collapsed on the ground, and he's mainly complaining of left-sided pain, left-sided injuries. He's taken a fair blow to his left side of his abdomen, and in there there's some important vessels, such as your spleen. He's obviously suffered some bad injuries today, and we need to get him into hospital and hopefully into the scanner and ascertain what injuries he's actually caused himself today.
En route to Waikato Hospital, the crew are helping to distract 7-year-old Jessica from the pain of her broken leg.
You can have a chat with her now, Dad.
Yes. Hear me, Jess?
Hi, Daddy.
Oh, how's it going?
Dad.
Yeah? That's good.
Jessica's dad is doing well at keeping everything as cheerful as possible.
Have a snooze for Dad. Main thing for Jess is pain relief for the curvature of the femur that there is. The bone is sort of splintered where it's been bent, but it's not completely in two halves. Usually there's some swelling around an injury like that. So we're halfway to the hospital now. Jessica's quite comfortable.
Clear out. Yep, I'll just make sure nobody comes on.
Jessica and her dad have finally reached hospital.
Thanks very much. Thanks to Westpac We Rescue. Helping my little girl out.
How was that, Jesse?
Good. Sweet as.
Better if you hadn't hurt your leg, eh?
Yeah.
And Dad's pretty casual about it all. Yep, he realises that's part of growing up. Not going to stop his kids swinging on a rope swing, like neither would I. Once they realign the bone and put the cast on, they'll check and check again. So she'll make a fine recovery and hope she has a good year at school.
Back at Kawakawa Bay, paramedic Chris Deacon is focused on closely monitoring Ian's serious back injury for any signs of deterioration.
Now, Ian, since we saw you, has there been anything that has changed? Have you got more pain or more pins and needles or...?
My shoulder is sore now, but...
Yeah, we'll get cracking.
But at the last moment, Ian's partner arrives.
What's your name?
Joyce.
Joyce. Is there anything that you want to ask about Ian?
What is it?
Well, at the moment, we're treating Ian for a spinal injury, so we don't know the extent. Okay. Treating him for the worst and hoping for the best. So we're going to take him through to Middlemore.
Yeah.
Where, yeah, they've got all the best facilities in the world for this sort of thing.
Their son is also waiting to say goodbye, although the situation is all a bit distressing for the youngster.
Yeah,
shouldn't be. Lucas.
Oh, no,
kiss
thanks.
Daddy? Kiss daddy? Kiss. No. Kiss.
No, mate.
Good on you,
good
mate.
Boy.
Good boy.
It will be 45 minutes before they are reunited at Middlemore Hospital.
Okay. Yeah, I'm fine. I'm used to it. How bad is that?
All set?
Yep, skip. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Airborne, Kawakawa Bay, 1 status 2 for Middlemore. ETA of 8 minutes over, and could we have an ambulance to take us around ED, thanks.
He's got tingling and numbness. He's quite sore in his lower back and in his neck. So we're a little bit worried about whether he may have sustained a serious spinal injury. We're just coming in now to land at Middlemore. We'll be met by an ambulance there and into the emergency department, where the emergency department team will take over his care.
Eyes will shut down.
Ian is now just minutes away from being assessed by the ED team. Hopefully, he has not suffered any permanent damage. The hospital tests revealed that Ian had a spinal sprain, which is now healed, but no spinal cord damage. Yet a head injury received in the accident has been an ongoing problem.
It took a while to be diagnosed with that mild traumatic brain injury. I'm having to sleep twice a day, getting headaches on a daily basis, and forgetting things. Forgetting things is the hardest, because I end up getting frustrated at myself, and then I start taking it out on other people. But when I start getting grumpy or tired or something like that, I know that it's time to go to bed and have a sleep. And
it's an ongoing process to recovery for Ian's entire family.
The ambulance staff rang my wife, and she came out. My son was there as well. And I was told afterwards that when the helicopter was taken off, that he was just crying, and hearing how upset that he was, that hurt. And I remember thinking in the helicopter that that could have been the last time that I had seen my wife and my son that morning. And that was a big kick in the guts and a big realisation that, hey, maybe it's time to just tone things down a little bit with my hobbies and that.
Ian believes that without the help from ambulance, fire and the helicopter crews, things could have been a lot worse.
The ambulance said, oh, the chopper's headed. That's when I realised that, well, this could be quite serious. I remember when Chris came into the back of the ambulance, because I used to watch him all the time on TV when I was a kid, and he was sort of my hero when I was younger, and he's like the man in the sky.
7-year-old Jessica was treated for a fractured right femur, but after 7 weeks recovery, is now doing well. David had surgery to repair his ruptured spleen and spent 2 weeks recovering in hospital. And Ian McDonald is grateful for everyone who has helped him on his journey back to full health.
Words can't describe how much I appreciate what they did. If it wasn't for them, it could be a totally different outcome. Definitely be helping them in the future, just to try and give back a small amount of what they did for me.